Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this Ask the Doc session by Gurgaon Moms. We are delighted to have with us today Dr. Aditi Bhatnagar. Dr. Aditi is a homeopathic physician and pediatrician. She is joining us today to share how we can use homeopathy to increase our immunity. Hello, Aditi. Welcome to this session. Unmute. Aditi, I think you're on mute.
Yeah, hi, Upasana. I'm extremely delighted to be here.
Thank you so much, Aditi. So in these times of COVID, this has been something that has been very often discussed. So I'm going to dive right in with the first question, Aditi. Yes. Can we use homeopathy to build immunity and how?
Oh, yes. You know, homeopathy for ages has been the go-to science to build homeopathy. You see, homeopathy actually works like vaccines in the sense that it creates an artificial disease condition in the body, and the body raises its immunity system to fight that disease. And during this process, the immunity of a person builds in. Now, not only that, there are a very beautiful, system of medicine in homeopathy that is called 12 tissue remedies, or they are commonly known as biocombinations. You know, I'm sure you must have heard about them.
Yes,
so
yes.
These biocombinations are basically composed or combination of 12 tissue salts, which are present in the body, like iron, magnesium, calcium. So when you have those, they help you build immunity. Yeah.
Okay.
So how? The question is, how do they help? You know, because there is a particular balance of minerals on one side of the membrane and, on the other side of the membrane. When this balance goes haywire, that is when disease happens. So these 12 tissue remedies, they actually help keep the balance right. And that is how we build the immunity.
Yeah. Okay, great. So Aditi, can you share, this question that I think is on everybody's minds, please forgive me if I pronounce the medicine names wrong. What is the prescription for arsenic album 30 or camphora during COVID?
Okay,
what's the story here?
You know, I had seen it coming because I have been answering so many calls and so many WhatsApp. Upasana, you'll have to actually travel with me into the history of homeopathy to get the answer. And trust me, by the time you hear the story, you yourself will have the answer, you know. So Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, who is the father of homeopathy, he discovered homeopathy. So
he's an allopathic doctor, I believe.
Yes. So that's the interesting part. Okay. He's an allopath, and he, while doing allopathy, during those times in Germany, you know, even bloodletting and so many other systems were prevalent. So he was totally disillusioned because he felt that the allopathic way doesn't surely cure the person. So he sort of closed down or abandoned his practice, and he just, spent his time translating medical journals. Can you beat it? And while translating Kulin's Materia Medica, so there's this Dr. Kulin who had written Materia Medica. And while he was translating that, he chanced upon an article about cinchona bark. So Peruvian bark, that's the name of the tree. So cinchona bark is the extract. So it says that if you consume cinchona bark produces symptoms of malarial fever. Yeah. So now it also said further down that if it is given to a person suffering from malaria, it will help cure it. But if it is given to a healthy person, it will create the symptoms of malarial fever in that healthy individual. And, you know, that thought struck Dr. Hahnemann. This is interesting, you know. It not only cures, but it can also produce. So what exactly is the working? So he himself consumed it and he found malaria-like symptoms, you know, in him. And he noted it all down. And from then on began his long series of experiments. But then, you know, the first law of homeopathy was formulated, that is similia similibus curantur, you know, that means like cures like. So, you know, Upasana, it's very important and interesting to know that every homeopathic medicine has been tested on human beings. Why? Okay. Because a human being can tell you what the person is feeling or going through. Yeah. So the medicine that anybody consumes, you know, they can cure the sick person if that person has that set of symptoms, but it can also produce those very set of symptoms in a healthy individual. So, you know, Upasana, you can very well understand, let it be arsenic, let it be camphor, or let it be Nux Vomica, China, so many medicines, you know, they all have the power to create that same set of symptoms in a healthy individual. So just imagine if somebody is taking arsenic album 30 and, you know, that person today doesn't have it, you know, have okay. that symptom. What will happen is the body will create an artificial symptom. Okay. And then you start sneezing because arsenic album is a very common anti-allergic, you know, it's used for hay fevers in the sense, you know, change of temperature and the person starts sneezing, or, you know, the person has burning pains, this, that, etc., etc. So now imagine a healthy person is having that. And if that person is very sensitive and that person starts showing the symptom, what we are going to do is just rush to the doctor and then.
Right. The whole... Then it's all. Okay. So, Aditi, tell me then, what are the safe remedies, especially for like cough and cold? Because that's, COVID is a respiratory disease. So, what can one do, you know? And do we take, so we don't take these drugs unless we consult with a homeopathic doctor. That's your take on it.
Absolutely. See, Upasana, you have to understand that in homeopathy, we say that, you know, no two people will be given the same medicine. Please try and understand that if two people come to me and both of them have, you know, a similar symptom of nasal discharge as well as watering from the eyes. But, right. you know, I want to ask that patient, you know, does your nasal discharge corrode your nose, you know, or do you have burning, you know, tears from your eyes? Because there is one remedy in homeopathy. Which talks about acrid nasal discharge and bland lacrimation. And there is another homeopathic medicine which says the exactly opposite. So, you know, I mean, you know, we all know that if we have to go to a homeopath, we have to be very, very, you know, clear that the homeopath is going to ask us a lot of questions and very funny questions also. So, you know, it's extremely important that, you know, you go to your homeopath, tell your homeopath your tendencies. And then your homeopath will formulate the medicines that you need for COVID, right? For your respiratory system, because maybe you have a sensitive respiratory system, so you might not need a 200 power or a 30 power, you might need 6 power. Yeah.
Right.
So that combination, of course, you must go to the homeopath. But having said that, yes, there are a lot of immunity builders also. For example, you know, we are all going to use ACs in this time, or, you know, people go out to exercise. So there is a little bit of inflammation caused by the pollens also, or by the dust allergy also. So there is ferrum fos.
Okay.
You know, you can use it in 3x power, 6x power. These are very, very safe medicines. As I said, these are bio combinations. So you can use ferrum fos, you can use Kali Moor. In fact, bio combination number 5 is for cough cold also, bio combination number 5 and 6. So you can start having those, you know, according to the dosage. If it's a child, then you can have 2 tablets 3 times a day. Or, you know, you can just ask your homeopath how to do it. In fact, there are instructions also. At the same time,
I was going to ask you this, Aditi. What is the story on Biocom? What is it? How effective is it? Like, you know.
So, you know, please understand that bio combinations are immunity builders. I use it quite often to build immunity because, as I said, you know, bio combinations are made up of the, you know, 12 minerals which are in our body, like iron, okay. calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, potassium. Right. So, you know, as I had said earlier also, let's take, for example, the respiratory system. So there is a particular balance of these, you know, minerals on one side of the membrane in the respiratory, you know, in the alveoli, and on the other side also. So whenever, you know, for example, if a person is allergic to dust, so this person goes out into the environment and there is this, you know, dust thing happening. And so the balance on the either side of the membrane gets disturbed. And that is when a symptom occurs. So when we take these bio combinations, they help keep the, you know, balance on the both side of membranes proper so that this person doesn't get those symptoms. So in a way, they are immunity builders. So bio combinations, I suppose, are, you know, to be used the maximum, you know, in the maximum power so that we really kind of build up our immunity.
Okay. I'll just move on to my next question, Aditi. There are many people who buy homeopathic medicines over the counter. Is that all right? And what about homeopathic kits? I've seen a lot of people making their own, you know, combinations at home.
Upasana, the thing is, I always say over-the-counter buying of drugs, be it of anypathy, is really, really bad. And especially when we are talking about, homeopathy, I feel that there is a lot yet to be discovered. I understand it's a very young science. And, you know, people find it very easy. They buy these repertories of Borike or Kent and they just look up a symptom and then they want to go and buy. But that's not so, because let's take the example of arsenic album. You know, in arsenic album, there is a mental symptom that the person is very scared. He feels that if he is not taken to the doctor at this very moment, he might die. You know?
Oh God.
So just imagine if somebody is taking arsenic album because that person is having sneezing, or, you know, probably the person is having some stomach issue because it's also used for food poisoning. And, you know, he's consuming 200 power or 1 M power or whatever, you know, just by reading or by, you know, asking somebody, what should I take? And then this person starts getting, you know, restless. So actually, you know, in homeopathy, there is a lot to do with mental symptoms also. You know, we observe the person, how he walks in, how he sits, what are his mentals, how does he talk? So over the counter absolutely is a big no-no. Buy only if your homeopath has told you, okay, I can't courier the medicine, you know, or something like that. Please do not read a book and just go, you know, because there's another beautiful medicine called Natramur. People use it. So, I mean, I've seen it on the Facebook.
Which one is that, Aditi? Just repeat the name.
It's called Natramur. So people use it for dermatitis, for eczema. But have people wondered that if you take Natramur, you might make the person prone to dandruff also.
Okay.
So, you know, you are trying to cure something and you are building something. So there is a very fine line between which power you are using.
Okay.
Yeah. And also, Upasana, the interesting part is in homeopathy, there is something called as the duration of action of a drug.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay. So for example, if you are having a slight cough and cold because you've had ice cream, so you should be choosing a medicine which has its action time of 4 hours or 6 hours or maybe a day or two, rather than immediately jumping to something like arsenic, which has, you know, a few days of duration of action. Mm-hmm. Why do you want that medicinal power or action to remain in your body for so long?
Correct. Okay. Yeah. There's a lot of eye openers in this for me also, because I didn't, know that there was so much science, like intricacies involved behind it. So yeah. Aditi, another question I have is, what are the do's and don'ts that one should observe while taking homeopathic medicine on a long-term basis?
Okay, of course, you know, we all know that building immunity is a slow process, and of course, we really need to be at it. But having said that, yes, there are certain do's and don'ts. The first one is, of course, you have to have the medicine when your mouth is free of all taste and smell. And when I say that, I also mean that, there should be no smell of the toothpaste.
Right.
We have all sorts of, minty and this and that flavors that come. Okay. So because, with the smell, the medicine gets neutralized. So the effect is, quite less. So even when you store medicine, homeopathic medicine, I always insist that if you're keeping it in your purse, please ensure that there are no perfumes kept, or, you don't keep your medicines in a place where there is agarbatti or camphor or other things, it neutralizes. So the first thing is that, of course, you need to, have medicine when your mouth is free of all smells. The second is, of course, there are certain few remedies which have, the necessity that you should not be having coffee or you should not be having something bitter or sour, but there are few medicines. So I think the homeopath will let you know what has to be, left, or it should not be consumed within a certain period of having homeopathic medicine. Otherwise, I think homeopathy is, good to go. There is not much do's and don'ts. I think there's a big halla out there of a lot of things which don't exist.
I see that. Okay. We have a question from one of our viewers. Prashansa Bagga wants to know. She says, please share your views on Moringa for immunity and also share which brand and how to take it. Is it safe for below 10-year-old children?
Okay, hi Prashansa, and I'm so happy that we are dabbling with so many natural substances because, you know, I am a homeopath, and trust me, being into homeopathy, you realize that these natural, you know, natural substances have so much power because homeopathic medicines are all made up from natural sources, be it mineral kingdom, animal kingdom, plant kingdom. So we come to Moringa that you've asked. I think Moringa, so I don't know if you know, what is Moringa? So Moringa is the drumstick tree that we are talking about, you know. So it's so commonly used in sambar and all, we use these drumsticks. So I always tell people, if you have a Moringa tree around, please make a vegetable out of it, like how we make methi, aloo and all. So Moringa is very, very good because it helps you increase your hemoglobin levels. It also increases your calcium levels and also absorption. It is a very good nerve strengthener. And trust me, Prashansa, during this COVID times, I tell people, please have Moringa if you can. If you have a tree, make a vegetable. And, you know, you find it like palak methi in so many, at so many vegetable vendors places also. Otherwise, there are capsules which are available. So you can definitely have capsules. But yes, as you asked very rightly, how do we give it to children, you know, small children below 10 years? So you have Moringa powder available as well. So you can simply, you know, I say a pinch is very good. A pinch of that powder is very good for a 3-year, 4-year, 5-year old child. You know, you can simply sprinkle it on his dry vegetable or put it in the raita or put it in the dal or put it in the roti and he's good to go. But as far as the brands are concerned, I'm really sorry. I can't really say because, you know, there are so many brands here. And, you know, there is Himalaya, there is Organic India, so many, and they are very good brands. So I think you can just go and pick it up. But the best thing is please make vegetable out of it and consume it.
Great. Thanks, Aditi. Thanks for that. Jyoti Narang also has asked the same question about camphora. So Jyoti, you'll have to rewind this Facebook Live because we addressed it to check out. We've already taken that question. I have another question from Ambika Monga Segal. She wants to know, Aditi, there are German homeopathic medicines and Indian. Which ones would you recommend? She hears that German ones are stronger. I know they're more expensive. So is there a difference?
Okay, so that's a very interesting question and a common one too. So please understand that homeopathy came to India at a very later stage. It was discovered and it was really, it flourished in Germany and in European countries. So the process of potentization or trituration, you know, these are the methods by which we make homeopathic medicines, was really very developed there. And it came very late to India. So there was a time, yes, when German medicines were a little higher in terms of efficiency. But I think now you will find German companies making their factories in India. There are factories, you know, but the Schaube and other companies, they have their base in India. So what they're using is also Indian and also, you know, some which they get. So, but that is the same with Indian companies because there are certain natural elements that you will get in India and certain that you'll have to import. So I feel, I mean, in these days, either ways, you know, you can take Indian brands, which are very good as well.
Okay, that's great. That's great, Aditi. So Aditi, my next question to you is by, again, from our community, Guni Tohri wants to know, what could be the reason for pain just below where the earlobe is connected to the skull? There is a popping sound and pain while eating. Guni, I would suggest you even speak to your dentist because I had this once and it was dental. But Aditi, I'll wait for your advice.
So, you know what you've said, Upasana, is very true. First, we need to diagnose the problem. But I know in these times, it would be very difficult to immediately just get up and go. But of course, scanning with the dentist is definitely on cards for you. But till that time, I always feel that immediately going up to the top rung and thinking what it might be and looking up for a disease, I think we first need to see if we are having our calcium right. Are we having our D3 also? Because these are small things. What is the hemoglobin level? What is the iron content? And you know, these days, you know, I joke with my clients that if you do not have a piece of land and if you are not growing your own vegetables, then please do pop in some calcium and, you know, D-rice or some iron and vitamins also, because, you know, the best of the vegetables that we buy, they do not really contain all the nutrients. So I'm not saying have it every day, but definitely sometimes. So, you know, my advice would be, please up your calcium content. You can have, you know, there are so many calcium supplements like GemCal, Calcimax, ShellCal, etc. So according to your age and according to your weight, just call up your GP and your GP will advise. And of course, have D-rice, because, you know, I'm sure we all agree that these days we do not really soak in the sun as much as we did earlier. And these days, because of COVID, I guess we are all locked in the house. So, you know, we definitely need to have our D-rice capsules. So first start having those. Maybe in 15 days or 20 days, you will see a difference. And then, you know, you will be able to decide much better. Definitely, of course, as I said, going to a dentist is on the card.
Thanks, Aditi. Isha Bhartia Agarwal is asking, how about using Calcarea Fos and BC21 for infants? What's your advice?
For what? She's using Calcarea Fos
and? Calcarea Fos and BC21. She hasn't mentioned for what. So do you want to wait for her to say for what?
Yes. See, because Isha, I said...
if Isha, if you're hearing this, just tell us for what, then we'll address your question. So I'll take the next question till then. Mansi Gupta wants to know. She says, my daughter's 10 years old. She started having 3 to 4 strands of gray hair. Could you please suggest, is there any medicine in homeopathy for this?
Okay, so hi, and you know, I know when our such young children start having strands of white hair or gray hair, we do get concerned. So I would actually first say, look into her calcium levels, look into her iron levels, you know, because whenever there is an imbalance, of course, you know, things will pop up. These are just symptoms of internal imbalance. Of course, heredity is one of the major things that we need to look into. If you know you had early graying in your family or in your husband's family, then of course the child is predisposed to, but then deficient, there certainly is some deficiency level which needs to be checked into. So look into her diet, and you know, then you will be able to scan out if it's vitamin deficiency or if it is you know, something else. So first fulfill the basic, you know, the pyramid has to grow stronger from the base. Look at the greens that she's having. Yeah.
Right. So Isha has mentioned for teething, Aditi, that is the question on Calcarea Fos and BC21 for infants.
Okay. So now one advice I would definitely want to give here is, if you are feeding the child right, you know, if you are giving good amount of calcium, like there is curd, there is milk, there is paneer, so many things, if you are giving the child, please don't go all out, you know, do not collect everything that has calcium and give your child, like BC21 also and Calcarea Fos also. I think Calcarea Fos is quite adequate if you are giving to a child. Yeah. The age of the child also matters. You know, should we be giving only Calcarea Fos and then Calcarea Fos 3X, or should we give 6X, or should we give Denton, or should we give this? So, you know, there are various levels. So your doctor will advise you. But my simple advice is, if your child is small and if you're giving your child a wholesome diet, please don't collect everything, you know, 21 also and Calcarea Fos. But Calcarea Fos in itself is a very powerful, you know, remedy. I'll tell you something. There are adults who are allergic to milk and milk products. And trust me, I give them Calcarea Fos 3X and they are absolutely fine. So sometimes only Calcarea Fos 3X does the trick. You do not need a lot of calcium.
However, do consult your doctor before starting anything. That would be our advice.
Yes.
Yeah. We have another question, Aditi. Someone wants to know whether there is any medicine in homeopathy for vitamin D.
For?
Vitamin D.
Vitamin D?
Yeah, to increase vitamin D.
I would suggest the best remedy is going out in the sun early in the morning. That's about it. That is one of the best.
Okay. We have Prabin asking, is there any medicine for increasing the diet for kids? I think he means increasing appetite.
Yes. You know, when we talk about homeopathic pediatrics, you know, the most important thing is improving the diet of the child. And you know, improving the diet means it means looking into the liver. It means looking if the you know, enzymes are being secreted properly. It's not only the hunger thing, you know, if the child is hungry, because there are so many people. I think 80 out of 100 people come to me and say ki, you know, mere bacche ko bhook nahi lagti hai, wo khata hi nahi hai kuch. You know, we have to understand ki use bhook kyun nahi lag rahi hai, kya use khana nahi acha lag raha, or the enzymes are deficient so that the person doesn't feel hungry, or the person is eating and it's not getting digested. So we have to look into multiple things. But having said that, as I've always said, that homeopathy looks into everything in detail. So visit a homeopath and discuss in detail, because there would be questions. How much is he eating? What are the timings? Does the child ask for food? And when the food is served in front of the child, does the child refuse? Or the second scenario would be the child is having 2-3 morsels of food and then the child says, no, I don't want food, you know? So there are a lot of things that need to be looked into. Also, constipation is another very glaring symptom which I have come across these days, you know, Upasana. So if the child has constipation, then this, you know, after 2-3 days, the child might not feel hungry. So we definitely need to stand out. And there are wonderful medicines, you know, in homeopathy to kind of regulate the digestive system of a child.
Right, right, definitely. So yes, please do look into it for sure. So Aditi, I've heard from a long time ago, I've heard there are steroids in homeopathic medicines. How do you test? How do you know? What is it? Is it a myth? Is it just, you know, one of those rumors?
So, you know, Upasana, we all eat sugar and we all know sugar is a steroid.
Yes.
So, you know, I always say that, yes, you know, if you take the sugar balls, sugar is a steroid, and homeopathic pills are made up of sugar, right?
Right.
So that, having said that, I always say, yes, if you want to check if there is steroid in the medicine, you have to take 2 bottles. You have to tell the homeopath, please give me one, you know, one bottle of pills which does not contain the medicine, because we homeopaths add all the dilutions in the pills and give.
Right.
Take the bottle which has the dilutions added, and another bottle which is, you know, just having sugar pills. Because trust me, in homeopathy, there are no steroids. So if I want to add steroid, I'll have to buy a steroid from the market, you know, liquefy it in water or whatever. And then I will have to put it in a bottle so that the patient doesn't know that this is a steroid, and then add it. So it's a lot of hard work. Yeah. So, but as it is in homeopathy, there are no steroid medicines as such. So get it checked if you want to get it checked, and please do get it checked if it is in your mind, but take an empty bottle also from the doctor, which only contains the pills. So if after testing, it comes out that in the, you know, the steroid level is equal in both the bottles, that means in the pills it's already been added, and that is an external addition. So, but as it is, homeopathy doesn't contain steroids.
Okay, thank you for clarifying that, Aditi. So Mansi Gogia's online, she thought Madhuri Dixit was live, Aditi, so she's thought you were
thank you so much.
Thank you.
Gives me a big smile on my face, you know, for managing this kind of condition. And trust me, here we have, you know, there are a lot of sportsmen who use arnica, and I think arnica is one medicine which is so common. So many parents also keep it in their house. When the child falls, somebody falls, and there is a cut or a bruise, you have arnica. So, you know, there are a lot of medicines apart from arnica. As I've said that there are various symptoms which need to be matched. So, Shruti, I will definitely urge you to visit your homeopath and talk about your symptoms in detail. When I'm saying talk about the symptoms in detail, see, because you might have pain, which is like a burning shooting pain. You might have a pain which is like, you know, as if somebody has just hit you. Or, you know, it might be a tiredness pain. So there are so many different types of pain. And in homeopathy, we definitely recognize the unique part of the patient, because, you know, that is what is unique with the person, that two people having pains will still have a different shade to a pain. And we have medicine for everything. So, yes, we can manage this condition very well with homeopathy. So do try to connect with your homeopath for this.
Okay. I have another question from Prashansa. She says, is there any medicine for women who get urine stress incontinence? I think she does exercise classes. Is there anything for women over 35 that they can take?
Absolutely. See, this is a very valid question, especially for women above 35. And also in this, you know, we have category of women who are, you know, after childbirth. So this is a question which comes very frequently to me. And I always say, yes, there are homeopathic medicines for this condition. And they're very, very effective. You can take it for some time and then, you know, maybe just keep one bottle with you if it starts again. But having said that, you need to do your exercises very well. There are Kegel exercises and there are other exercises also which your doctor will guide you. Apart from that, please do take nerve strengtheners as well. In homeopathy, there are very beautiful nerve strengtheners which can help you, improve the nerve strength so that this doesn't happen. So apart from that, as we talked about Moringa, which is another nerve strengthener, which is, you know, which is absolutely wonderful. So after 30, as women, we definitely need to look into our calcium levels, into our vitamin levels, into our mineral levels. You know, people forget the micronutrients like zinc and silica, in our diet or in our bodies. So that needs to be looked into as well. So yes, coming back to your question, yes, there are wonderful medicines in homeopathy for that. But having said that, also put yourself on some nerve strengtheners like Moringa, Brahmi, Ashwagandha, which will help you in, handling this and also get into exercising.
Great. I'm just going to take 2-3 more quick questions, Aditi. Sure. Prachi Chopra says, my 7-year-old feels cold all the time. Is it due to some deficiency? She's looking for warm water for a bath and being with the air conditioning as well, but she loves ice cream.
Okay. So hi, Prachi. This is such a lovely question. You know, you want ice cream and yet you seek warmth. So, you know, this is a very beautiful, this is a symptom in homeopathy. Trust me, Prachi, if you, visit your homeopath, the homeopath will look out for that remedy which says that desires cold and yet feels cold. So, you know, we have very beautiful symptoms in homeopathy that we need to hunt out. One thing that I would definitely advise you, Prachi, is please, get her regular blood scan because we need to know her iron content. There are times when the child is anemic and, there is a B12 deficiency also. So these deficiency can make a person, a little lower on the side. And that is why, you start feeling cold all the time. Of course, liking ice creams and all this is a different part. For that, of course, we are not going to give any homeopathy medicine so that the child gets aversion to ice cream. But yes, we need to look into her iron content and B12 content. But as I said, during COVID times, of course, avoid getting a blood test done. So you can always put her on biocombination 1 and also on biocombination 28. It's written tonic on 28. So biocombination 28 is a very beautiful biocomb which can be given to people of all ages because it keeps your entire body healthy and fit. So put her on Biocom 1, put her on Biocom 28 till the time you are unable to connect with your homeopath and get the blood scan done. I'm sure she'll improve.
Thanks, Aditi. We have a question from Ritu Jain. Okay. She says, my son is 23 and is not able to have deep sleep. Can you advise some medicine for that?
Okay, so whenever we are talking about deep sleep, we are talking about high stress or anxiety. Or, there might be a condition for sleeplessness. So we need to really scan into all this. Having said that, if you have looked into the stress aspect, the anxiety aspect, yes, there are wonderful medicines in homeopathy. There is, there is Kalifos, which is again a biocombination, which you can have so that the person's, stress is a fact of life. Even my 15-year-old says I am stressed. My, 10-year-old will say they have a lot of stress because they have so much to do. So what I'm trying to say is that, yes, stress is a part of life and we need to up our nerve strength to be able to deal with all of it. So there are wonderful medicines like Kalifos 3X, 6X power you can easily get and start having it so that you are able to deal with your stress and anxiety. And of course, yoga, Anulom Vilom will also help you. But There are other medicines like Passiflora, like Tranquil in homeopathy, which help you get a nice deep sleep. So I'm revealing a few names, not because you should immediately go and get them over the counter, but just to tell you that yes, there are wonderful medicines. But as I said, symptoms need to be scanned. Why is there this condition? Because in homeopathy, we believe that the symptoms are only a way of the body to tell you that there is something amiss in the system, which needs to be set right. And what we need to find out is the cause. Yeah?
Right. Definitely. Okay. We have another question from Neha Mathur. She says, my father has bad arthritis and severe pain in the knee. I can't take him to the doctor because of the lockdown. Can you please guide what can be given to him for relief?
Okay, so this is a very lovely question. What can be given for relief? Yeah, because arthritis, I think for homeopathy, there are certain diseases like asthma or eczema and arthritis, which are very, which homeopaths do get very often because these are deep seated and they require a long time. Yet they have given, homeopathic medicines have given wonderful result. So when we're talking about arthritis, please call up the doctor, call up the homeopath, because as I said that no two pains are same in homeopathy. So I will need to know if pain is more when your father gets up from the sitting position and just starts walking, because there is a remedy in homeopathy which says that pain is aggravated on immediate movement, on the first movements, but it grows better on walking a little while. And there is another remedy which says that the patient gets pain in the knee only on walking, only after walking for some time. So, these are two absolutely opposite symptoms. And then, there are some people who feel better when they apply the hot water bag or they apply some warmth on the knee. The pain recedes, but for some it doesn't work. So, honestly speaking, I should not be advising you anything, because you need to go to a homeopath and talk out these symptoms. And trust me, every homeopath will ask you, okay, so dard kab badhta hai? Jab aaram karte hai tab badhta hai ya jab uthte hai tab badhta hai? Chalte mein dard badhta hai ya baithe mein dard badhta hai? Garam se aaram milta hai ya nahi? So these are the very common questions. But yes, for relief, I will say for a short time, if your father is in real pain right now, because I know for us, our parents are the most important thing. So if he's in real pain right now, you can definitely give him Arnica mother tincture and Restox mother tincture. Give him 10 drops in like half a cup of water. He will get some relief, but do not give it as a long-term thing. And trust me, we homeopaths are doing a lot of video calling, a lot of video consultations, and couriers have started. So please pick up the phone, look up for your homeopath and talk to the homeopath, because what he needs is the perfect remedy, not for relief, but for cure.
Great. Thanks, Aditi. So Aditi, I want to know, tell us your experiences with your teenagers, with your boys, when you suggest things to them.
Oh my God. I think...
I want something.
Okay. So, Pasna, what I want to really say is that, yes, my boys have grown up on homeopathy. So my elder one was a born asthmatic, if I talk about my personal experience. And so when he was born, imagine the fourth or the fifth day and my child is wheezing. So when you are a mother, you are not a doctor. Like I say, I could never hear wheeze in my child's chest, though he was an asthmatic. I didn't want to hear it. So, I simply took him to the doctor. I said, what to do? And I would watch him. But by the time he was 5 or 6 months old, he had to be on nebulizer. He had to be on this and that and everything. And that was the day I said, no. Okay. I'm a homeopath. I'm a homeopathic pediatrician. I need to, put him on homeopathy. Having said that, I gave him homeopathy for a good 3 to 4 years and he recovered so beautifully that we've gone to Switzerland and everywhere. And can you beat it? I was sneezing or I had this nasal discharge and he didn't have any. And he would say, see, mom, this is what you've done to me. You've made me stronger. Then he said, no, because then for teenagers, giving credit to their parents is a big deal. They said, homeopathy did it.
Yeah.
Yes, homeopathy did. So jokes apart, I want to actually say this, I want to narrate a small incident. I think teenagers in this time and this era are much more curious, to accept and see things. They want to know a lot about it. See, I had a patient last year, and this patient was a epileptic child. Yeah, so he was studying in a daily school and in the special category. So with a lot of steroids and a lot of medicines, he grew obese, this, that. So he became a sort of a recluse and all that. So when his mother got him to me, so he would say, no, I just want to, you know, kind of just pass in the exams in 12th standard. I have no dreams. I just probably I'll become a chef. I'll become something. And with his monthly consultations and all, he started opening up. And let me tell you, Upasana, this guy topped in the whole Delhi in special category. So if his mother is watching, his mother knows that I'm so proud of him. And I've been telling this to so many people. And you know, the secret for his getting well or responding so well to homeopathy was that he said, okay, if this is the medicine or this is the pathy which is going to make me reduce the dose of my epileptic medicines, then I'm going to have it. And he would go and read it. And today this guy, you know, just imagine topping in the whole Delhi 12th standard in the special category for somebody who said, I'll just get 30-40%. You know, so I feel these days teenagers are very open to knowledge. They are very open to accepting new things. It's not like, you know, I remember when I was small, my parents would take me to the doctor and he would say something and he would give me something and I would simply have it because my parents took me and my doctor said something. These days teenagers are much more involved in what they do. So, great. I think it's a great sign.
Okay. I'm coming to my last question. It's something similar to Bindiya also asked something. Please share, Aditi, three easy things that we should do, that anyone and everyone should do starting now, given the situation around us. Bindiya had asked whether there's any homeopathic medicine we as parents should keep at home for like,
You don't need to boil it for 5 minutes. What I say is boil water and pour it in a cup. And in that cup, add a little, add a little bit of dalchini, one pepper and one black pepper and one clove, and allow it to, you know, sort of steep for 10 to 15 minutes till that time the water becomes room temperature. And then remove that and add, remove the three things, that is clove, dalchini and black pepper, and add a little bit of turmeric.
Okay.
And simply so drink clove, it. So every day it has
to. I'll just repeat it once. Clove, cinnamon, turmeric in hot water.
Yes. Also clove, pepper, black pepper.
Black pepper. Okay. Black, three, four things. Black pepper, clove, cinnamon, turmeric in hot water.
In hot water and allow it to remain, you know, it's not always, I'm not saying that you have to have it boiling or very warm. You can simply allow it to come to room temperature, but have it every day because that really keeps your entire system very well. And then coming to homeopathy, yes, I do advise having biocombination 1, which is for anemia, biocombination number 28. These are two absolutely necessary tonics to have and also to be given to children. Every single day, if you are not having any condition of anemia and any deficiencies, have at least one dose. So if it's a child below 10 years, you can give 2 tablets once a day. If it's a person above 10 years, you can have 4 tablets every day. But of course, if you have a condition, then 2 times or 3 times as is recommended. Another thing is, yes, have 2 tablespoons of ghee every day. So that is one thing that I really adhere to. Also, Moringa capsules or Brahmi or Ashwagandha, whichever you sort of resonate to well, you can have those. So these are the 2-3 things that I feel would hold you in good stead, in the surrounding where COVID is so prevalent and, we are homebound. So it's very important to keep healthy.
Yeah. Aditi, can we add something like jaggery or, Mishri to the kada just to make it easier for kids? Honey.
Yes, honey is wonderful. Honey is good. Even jaggery is good. Whatever your child... when you're giving it to a child, it doesn't have to be a whole cup of water. It can simply be, half a spoon of water and half spoon of honey. So you can just mix it and give it.
Right. Okay, that's important, I guess. So great, Aditi. Thank you so much for your time. And everyone, Aditi's contact details will be in the comments section. And we really appreciate all of you logging in. Stay safe, stay at home. Thanks a lot, Aditi, for your time and for patiently answering all these questions. We really, really appreciate it.
Thank you. My pleasure, Upasana. Thanks for having me here. Have a good day. Be safe. And it's okay if COVID is there. We are stronger than COVID. Yeah.
Absolutely agree.